Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky's chief of staff said that Ukraine is to start consultations with the United States this week on providing security guarantees for Kyiv, pending the completion of the process of joining NATO. Andrei Yermak said that the officials from a number of countries were preparing to meet in Saudi Arabia to discuss Zelensky's peace plan for Ukraine based on the departure of all Russian troops. The Wall Street Journal first reported on the meeting in Saudi Arabia on Saturday, saying that it would be held in Jeddah on August 5th to 6th. The talks on security guarantees with the United States are a follow-up on pledges issued by the Group of Seven or G7 at the NATO summit in Lithuania earlier this month to draw up and honor security guarantees. Yermak said that the guarantees will be in effect until Ukraine secures NATO membership. The Western Alliance's Vilnius summit offered support to Ukraine in countering Russia's 17-month-old invasion, and individual countries pledged new weapons, but no date for Ukrainian membership was set as long as the war continues. Members of the G7 agreed to each nation to negotiate agreements to provide security guarantees and help Ukraine bolster its military. In his comments, Yermak said that more than 10 countries had joined the G7 declaration and Ukraine was negotiating terms of future guarantees with each of them. Yermak spoke of the forthcoming meeting in Saudi Arabia at a gathering of regional officials in the western Ukrainian city of Ivano-Frankivsk. He said that an initial international meeting devoted to the peace plan took place in Copenhagen in June. In addition to calling for a withdrawal of Russian troops, Zelensky's peace plan also provides for the restoration of Ukraine's pre-war borders and the return home of all prisoners and deported children. Russia and Ukraine held a series of peace talks soon after Russia's invasion in February in last year, but these failed to produce any agreement. Ukraine, its military now bolstered by Western arms, now says that it will not take part in any further talks until Russian troops leave.